Good morning, comrades. This is Natum Loke back again with another video. So in this video, we will be discussing about the preamble of the Indian Constitution. So, or ek baat hai, there has been some questions regarding how to read Lakshmikant. So there is no special trick, but you can do one thing. Whenever you are reading your president, you read about the government. Whenever you are reading about the prime minister, you read about the chief minister. Whenever you are reading about the parliament, you read about the state legislature. Whenever you are reading about the Supreme Court, you read about the High Court also. That way, it will be more convenient to complete the this Lakshmikant and understand it more properly. Thank you. Of Indian Constitution. So, what is preamble? So, preamble is the introduction or preface to the Constitution, or it is also called identity card of the Constitution by N.A. Pakhiwala. N.A. Pakhiwala called that preamble is identity card of the Constitution. So American Constitution was the first Constitution to have a preamble, and Indian Constitution borrowed it from there. But Indian Constitution, the preamble in the Indian Constitution is based on the objective resolution as drafted by Pandit Nehru. Also, the preamble of Indian Constitution has been amended once, that is in 1976 by 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act. So by that amendment, three words, socialist, secular and integrity, were added to this preamble. So preamble is a part of Constitution which was declared in Kesav Anand Bharti case 1973. So pehle mein Birubari case mein bola tha ki preamble is not the part of the Constitution, or preamble ko isliye amend nahi kar sakta hai bola tha, lekin Kesav Anand Bharti case mein bola ki preamble is a part of Constitution and preamble can be thus amended. So then it is said that whenever, like, the importance of preamble is that whenever there is difficulty of interpreting the Constitution, the preamble can be used, or the Constitution can be interpreted in the light of the preamble. So wo bolte hai, and preamble has some specific terms like sovereignty, secular, sovereignty, socialist, secular and democratic republic. So ye sab term hai, important keywords, so important adjectives. So these are usually asked in the mains examination or prelims mein bhi pucha jata hai kabhi kabhi. So you have to memorize the preamble of the Indian Constitution. Actually memorize karke rakhe to acha hai, zyada lamba bhi nahi hai. So preamble ka jo meaning wo hai, ye keywords ka thoda meaning dekh lete hain hum log. To isme aisa hai ki this what does sovereignty mean? Sovereignty means that a country is independent and it is not a dependency of any country. It is independent in sense of external and both internal डिसीजन मेकिंग्स, अपना डिसीजन खुद ले सकता है, किसी का प्रेशर में नहीं आएगा. सो इट इज़ इंडिपेंडेंट इन देंस सेंस, तो उसको सॉवरेनिटी बोलते हैं, स्वयं प्रभुता बोलते हैं हिंदी में उसको. सो अपना मालिक खुद. सो व्हाट डज दिस सोशलिज्म सोशलिस्ट मीन्स? तो इसमें ऐसे है कि मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन जो है कि स्टेट का हाथ में रहेगा. मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज जो है स्टेट का हाथ में बेसिकली रहता है, तो प्राइवेट प्लेयर का स्पेस नहीं होता है. बट इन इंडिया इट इज़ नॉट लाइक दैट. इंडिया फॉलोज डेमोक्रेटिक सोशलिज्म जो कि मिक्स इकोनॉमी, इट हेल्प्स फेट इन मिक्स इकोनॉमी. इंडिया हेल्प्स फेट इन मिक्स इकोनॉमी. तो मिक्स इकोनॉमी में क्या होता है कि सम थिंग्स आर गिवन टू प्राइवेट सेक्टर एंड सम ऑफ द थिंग्स आर कैप्ट विद द गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर. सो इट्स लाइक दैट. सो देन व्हाट इज सेकुलर? सेकुलर मीन्स ऑल रिलीजन इन द कंट्री हैव सेम स्टेटस एंड सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द स्टेट. देयर इज नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन द नेम ऑफ योर रिलीजन, और एवरी रिलीजन इज रेस्पेक्टेड इक्वली. So that is secularism, and there is a concept called principal distance model in India. So that we can discuss later on if needed. And then democracy. So democracy, everyone knows what is democracy. Democracy is the government of the people, for the people, by and by the people. So that is democracy. So democracies are of two type, direct and indirect democracy. So in indirect democracy, people exercise their supreme power directly, and there are four devices of direct democracy, that is referendum, initiative, recall and plebiscite. In indirect democracy, representative held by people exercise the supreme power. So in India basically it is your indirect democracy. And so then what is republic? Republic is a system where the head of the state is elected and not hereditary. So इसीलिए India republic है, क्योंकि president को India में elect किया जाता है, unlike UK में जहाँ में कि उसको हेरिडेटरी होता है प्रेसिडेंट जो. सो दैट इज रिपब्लिक. सो जस्टिस, द प्रीएम्बल क्लारिफाइज दैट इट एंडेवर्स टुवर्ड्स एंश्योरिंग जस्टिस ऑफ सोशियो इकोनॉमिक पॉलिटिकल जस्टिस. सो दिस थिंग्स आर आस्क्ड sometimes in the prelims as it is, so you have to memorize these things. Social justice means equal treatment of all citizens without any discrimination. Economic justice means needs of the people must be fulfilled and there shall be equality of opportunity. And political justice include right to vote, contest election and hold public office. So these are the things, justice and liberty. Liberty in what sense? Liberty in the sense of your thought, expression, belief, faith and worship. So liberty in this sense. So you have to remember these words, thoughts, expression, belief, faith and worship. And equality, then equality, it means absence of special privileges to any section of the any section and provision of adequate opportunities for all individuals without any discrimination. So this is equality without any discrimination, but there people argue about protective discrimination, but that's a different topic altogether, reservation ka issue. So we will talk about it. And then ensuring fraternity in the sense of brotherhood and oneness. So that is preamble. So this is part